Okay, guys, look, I know that I have not been uploading that much to this channel as of late, and I promise you it's because, you know, I've been going to college as of late, and I've been also trying to figure out the direction of what kind of videos I want to be making. So please expect some high-quality Karam content in the future. Now, as you might have seen in the title, I got a key to the city over this winter in January. And I didn't really know this was something that happened in real life. The key to the city was just kind of something that, like, Superman would be given after he saved the cat out of a tree or killed some other interdimensional god that came to attack. Or, I don't know, he gets a lot of keys to cities, I imagine. But that being said, in fact, no. They are real things that you can go out and if you do sufficient side quests, people will just give them to you. So, I'm being totally honest with you. This is it right here. It's the key to the city of Paris, California. And within this box is everything that I need to show you to prove that I got the key to the city to a town in these United States of America. So sit back, relax, and enjoy while I tell you about this completely cartoonish episode in my life. So before we start, this is actually the key to the city that I got. Funny enough, it's a lot smaller than I thought it would be. I don't know why I expected it to be like in the cartoons where they give you like a massive situation, but no, it's just a little thing that you pin onto your shirt. And, I mean, it's a real key. I think it might open something. Maybe if I go to the city of Paris, California's town hall or whatever, then it would be like, you know, I'd be given hospitality or something like that. I don't know. This has to have some use. They're not just going to make these for no reason whatsoever. But yeah. So, essentially, it's January of 2024, and, you know, you guys might not know this about me, but I'm very politically motivated. I'm studying international and political affairs at Brown University right now, and I'm going around looking for jobs for the summer to see what can I do, and one of my ideas was that I was going to intern for my local senator. I live in New Jersey, and the senator I was looking for was Cory Booker. The other one, Bob Menendez. I don't know if you know, but he's probably not the guy to be looking for from a job around this time. That being said, I go to Senator Cory Booker's office and I'm greeted by his interns that are there. And they're a really fantastic group of people. They're young, you know, they're just like me to a certain extent. And we're just really chatting it up just about what the job is like, what are some of the expectations, how is it like in DC, stuff like that. And later on, you know, Senator Cory Booker is actually walking back and forth in the door adjacent to it. So, you know, we were seeing him and then his interns were like, oh, do you want to meet the senator? I'd love to, I said. And then they called him over and Senator Cory Booker just came and he was right in front of me. Something that, you know, you don't initially see from the photos is that he's way bigger than you think he is. The guy's like 6'2", 6'3". Like, he's a massive handshake kind of situation. So I didn't expect that. But, you know, he's a very cool guy, I thought at least. So we had a great chat. He asked me about, you know, my name, where I'm from. And we had just had a great 5-minute chat. And as he left, I just went back to his interns. And they actually offered me then, as a result, this ticket. Now, this is not a very special item, to be sure. Basically, it's this little pass to go in and sit in on the United States Senate while they're in session doing their various activities. And anyone can get it, to be really honest with you, but it takes a little bit of a wait time. They gave it to me for free because they just had a stack of them. And I decided I would just go to the Senate House and just see what was going on in that room. What were they working on? So, we're in the line to view the Senate, and there's about three groups. There's me, which is one group. There's a group of about 54 high school students in DC doing some sort of tour. And there's another group of three, which I later found out was the mayor of Paris, California, and his entourage, like his assistant, etc., that were going in to look at the new senator that had just replaced Dianne Feinstein at the time and was about to give what they call their maiden speech. A maiden speech is the first ever speech that a senator gives while in session, and usually it's a big event. Other senators come and they, you know, congratulate you on it, and they came over to watch that. Essentially, right before they let you into the Senate room, though, you have to put all your phones and anything that could, like, make a sound or record into these various cubbies with this little blue placard that indicates what cubby that you have so you can retrieve your items later on. So we go through this entire process and we start walking through the various securities that they have between, you know, the public and the Senate room. Something I kind of noticed is probably A, after the Capitol riot on January 6th, they probably had to beef up the security. But the way that they did it was not by improving each of the security, you know, apparatuses, but by just making more security. So we ended up having to walk through like 6 metal detectors on the way there, but they were all essentially the same overall. Now, the third line of security was just some guy who was making sure that we had both this blue piece of paper and the blue placard that indicated what your cubby was. And the manager to the mayor and his entourage, they had the blue placard, but they didn't have the blue piece of paper that I had. So while we're just standing in front of this guy, he's giving them some flack for not having it. We don't know if he's going to let them in. And it was at that point that I just showed my blue piece of paper, and I'm like, no, they're with me. We're all just one group going in. And I think that this just gave us enough credibility that he let the entire group of us four pass and to go watch in the Senate room. As we're going, I'm meeting with the guys, and the manager, the mayor, tells me, hey, if you hadn't had helped us out, then we probably would not have been able to see this person's speech, because, you know, it started at 3:15, it was already well into the speech period. We would have missed it if you had not, you know, done the voucher for us. So I'm talking right now mainly with the manager, the mayor. His name is Wendell. He's an amazing, you know, very awesome guy. And we're chatting about basically anything under the sun. We were just having a great time. About an hour, we watched a speech. We had a few other speeches from the senators from North Carolina and from West Virginia. We were just ragging on Biden's energy policy. It was a whole separate thing. But essentially, as we walk out and we're back in the cubby room, the manager, the mayor, says, you know, hey, Karim, you really helped us out there. Would you like the key to the city? And I was kind of, again, taken aback. I didn't really know anything that was happening. I think I'll put a video right here of it actually happening at the moment. You can see that I don't even remember to shake his hand because I'm just so taken aback by what the hell is even happening with my life right now. This is an actual key to the city that was like an actual real life situation. But yeah, I got the key, the video I'll have for the rest of my life. I'm putting that shit on my resume for sure. I mean, recipient of a key to a city, that's like a high level honor. I'm basically Superman at this point. You know, that's what I'm going to tell my kids, at least. They're going to be knowing all about that. So that's how I went into Washington, D.C. looking for a job and left with a key to a city for a town with a population of about 80,000, about 30 miles out of Laguna Beach. The clincher to this story is that I actually got rejected for the internship too. So really, this is all I have to show for that situation. But if I had to do it a million times over, I would. Because again, who's getting keys to the city in 2024?
On behalf of the city of Paris, I'd like to extend a thank you to Karim, who is interested in government, but also just interested in the way we function as a society. And with that, I provide him the key to the city of Paris, California. Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.